righteousness, peace, war, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God. Everybody sing righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Oh, righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom.
Precious saints, have you lost your joy? Have you lost your peace? Have you lost the love of God in your heart? In this week's broadcast, Sam Melan, together with his guest, shares practical ways on how you can walk in the joy of God. For the Bible says, the joy of the Lord is your strength. So no day should find you weak. Every day should be a strong day for you because of the joy of the Lord. Now, here is Sam.
Hallelujah.
Man of God, it's me.
It's been such a blessing. I just love that, people of God, it's been such a blessing in this broadcast this week. You know, trying to see how, why God wants to enshrine his characters in us. And we see that one of the characters that God, through his spirit, is sculpturing and trying to build in us is the character of love. In a world of hatred, in a world of all kinds of envy, God just says, man, you have to walk in my love. This is because God is love. He's not hope. He's not faith. He's not prayer. He's not Sunday morning church service. He's not those things. He's love. God is love. Amen. Now we see, please, one of the attitudes that God desires to build in us so we can become agents of change is joy.
Joy.
The attitude of joy. My God. In fact, when God began dealing with me on this, I just got so blessed. You know, why God wants to put joy in us? Because we live in a world that wants to be happy. Get a new day, get a new sugar. And because of that drive for happiness, we'll do everything to get it. We can go against human principles just because we want to be happy. But truth is, God says, I know that, you know, I just believe this because, you know, God doesn't just want to make us happy. Yes, you can be happy. He can bless you, yes. But truth is, he wants to give you joy. Now, what is joy? It is that inner excitement, that inside gladness, that thing that maybe there is no new shoe, there is no money, there is no food, but you are excited. You are robust. You are not sad. You are not gloomy. You are not moody. And there are people that, you know, they can't pick their cause, not because, you know, things are not going the way they want. They are broke, they are hungry, and so they are angry with everybody around. And they say, hungry man is an angry man. So when they're hungry, they get angry. But in joy, the Bible says, you know, in Matthew 4, that Jesus, after fasting, he was hungry. Yeah. He wasn't angry.
Yeah.
And because anger is the fruit, is the work of the flesh. He wasn't angry. So we see that. He was having joy because it was joy that gave Jesus the ability to overcome all the temptations of Satan. It was joy because if he was angry and not happy, you know, he would have missed out. So we see that joy is one of the principal cardinal character that the Holy Spirit wants to enshrine the believer in this end time. For I call joy the winning attitude.
Hallelujah.
Man of
God. Praise. Let's see the scripture. Romans 14 verse 17.
Praise. Romans 14, 17.
Yeah. It's written, for the kingdom of God is not meat and drink.
Praise.
But is but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost.
In the Holy Ghost.
That's something. This kingdom is these three principles must follow. And joy in the Holy Ghost. And joy doesn't depend on the money. It doesn't depend on the good shirts and good clothes and shoes, but it depends on the Holy Ghost. No matter what situation we are going through, it's joy. Because when Stephen, we remember the character of Stephen, and Stephen was stoned to death, he can look upon and say, Father, forgive them. And that's joy.
In the face of trials, in the face of temptations, in the face of hardships, in the face of you know all kinds of things, because we live in the world, and the Bible says in John 16:33, Jesus says in the world you will have tribulations,
or tribulations.
Trench robbers come at the same time. But it says that's in the Word. So because we live in the Word, there are trials, there are tribulations. But it says, but be of good cheer. That's joy.
Yes.
Be of good cheer because I have overcome the world for you.
Yes.
So joy is you just being of being good, having good cheer. You were excited. You were laughing.
Let's read that scripture in Romans 4, but Abraham got it. I love this.
Hallelujah. God wants you to have joy. Joy in the face of trials and storms. Look at this. Romans 4, verse number 19 and verse number 20. He says, talking about Abraham, he says, and being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body, now dead, when he was about 100 years old, neither yet the deadly of Sarah's work was 20. He staggered not at my ever said, man, if for 25, at 100, had no child from his wife.
Yeah.
But the Bible said, verse 20, he staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith. Doing what? Giving glory to God. Man, he was strong in the face of trials. He was strong in faith, he said, and he was giving glory. As soon as from this scripture, we see Abraham as an excited man. He was so excited. He was strong in faith. Because he didn't even consider the weakness of his body or that Sarah's womb was dead. He was just giving praise. He said, Father, in the face of Sarah's barrenness, he said, Father, I thank you. He was always thanking God. Always giving God praise. That is joy. You can get up in the face of disaster. You can say, you can lift up your hands up and your heart and say, Father, I thank you. You can say, go to church, even in our offerings. Praise God. Because the joy of the Lord. You know what the Bible says? I like this Nehemiah now. Look at this.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. You can give glory to God. You can be of good cheer in the face of circumstances. I mean it. You can be excited. Because the joy of the Lord is inside of you. Praise God. Look at this. Nehemiah 8 verse 10. I love this. He says, then Nehemiah said to them, go your way. He says, eat and be fat. He says, drink the sweet and set portions unto them for whom nothing is prepared. He says, for this day is holy unto our God. He says, neither be ye sorry, for the joy of the Lord in our life is our strength. Hallelujah. It says, for the joy of the Lord. So when you miss the joy, you lose the strength. I don't know what the Bible says in the 10th proverb. He says, if you faint in the time of adversity, your strength is small. So what carries you through adversity is joy. Joy. Because joy is like the anointing that releases the strength of God in you. You can face anything. You can go through any challenge. In the joy of the Lord. He says the joy of the Lord is our strength. You can see men telling Daniel, today you'll be a meal for the lions. And he was lying.
Hallelujah.
You can see them telling Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who were thrown in that forest. And they were smiling. Oh, King, live forever. Even though our God cannot deliver us, who will not bow? That is not. In fact, I call this joy is the strength of faith.
Oh,
joy. Yes, joy. My God.
Praise God.
Joy.
That's so important because it's written in the same Nehemiah 8 verse 10. The joy is the strength of a believer. That means how will you know a believer is strong or weak is by his joy.
He doesn't complain. There are believers when small things happen, they call temperances, just complain about the economy of their nation, about everything. That's because they lack the joy of the Lord. And so that was the there was the other dimension of this joy because it is from the Holy Ghost. You know, from this man of God, if somebody buys you a car, you are excited.
Yeah.
As a physical thing that makes you happy. You are happy. And that's because you got a new car or a new shoe but or a new house. Now, but there's something God does to us. Now, whenever the Holy Ghost, whenever God does something in the realm of the Spirit, one of the signs I notice that God, the Holy Ghost begins to excite my spirit. Now whenever I notice an excitement in my spirit, then something has been done for me in the spirit.
No matter what situation is my
great. So joy is like a signal, a sign that something has been done in the spirit for me. Even as somebody buys you a house physically and you're excited. So when God does anything for you, the Holy Ghost begins to give you joy to excite you. So you may not see it physically, but you're excited. It's a sign that, and that's why you start singing. You sing, but with a hard time, you're singing, you're dancing. You know, like the widow, the widow's mind. She came to give the offering, and she was dancing and giving the offering. The mind, because there was joy in her spirit that something has happened. Oh, child of God, child of God, I want to tell you this. You don't lose your joy. There's so much out there. Yes, you know, God did not promise us a world without problems, a world without challenges. But He says, be of good cheer. Don't lose your joy. You can overcome. He says, the joy of the Lord. I want to pray for you personally. That you are losing your joy. You are complaining. You get weaker and weaker because your strength is in joy. He says, the joy of the Lord. The joy, I pray a day for you. Whatever the challenge is with you, whatever the circumstances, whatever life has situated you, I release the joy of the Lord. I release an excitement in your spirit right now. The Bible says when Mary knocked on the door of Elizabeth, the baby in her womb leaped for joy. I pray, I command everything within you to leap for joy. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. And don't forget this. Whatever the circumstances, oh, I love joy. My goodness. Don't forget this. You are a blessing.